Hi, my name's Cody and I'm with LaunchDarkly. And in this video, we're going to build a React application from the ground up and integrate it with LaunchDarkly. We'll be using LaunchDarkly feature flags to change the way the application works based on the feature flag values. In this video, we're going to focus on a true or false flag and swap out a single component. But in the next video, we'll expand out to using a string flag that changes content as well as conditionally loads React components based on those flag values. If you're following that at home, you'll want to make sure you have NPM installed as well as Create React App installed. It's going to be a lot of fun, so let's get after it. Out of the gate, we'll start on our command line. We'll go ahead and do our Create React App, and we'll use, in my case, the LD Lightspeed application. That's the one that I had been testing against. And we can see that our bootstrapping is taking place now. So what's happening is Create React App is effectively scaffolding out just a basic React-based application. It's getting all of the initial components built, all of the directory structure, building it out in a friendly little directory that we can use to build off of. So we're done now, so we'll go ahead and switch into that directory. And we can see our components here. We'll go ahead and do an npm install of the LaunchDarkly React Client SDK. And with that installed, we'll go ahead and launch VS Code and start exploring the code. We open up the source directory, we can see all the components for React. The index is our base of our web application, which launches app, and then inside app is where our actual application itself lives. In order to bring the LaunchDarkly client SDK that we just installed into our application, we need to import it into our React components. We'll go ahead and do an import, and we can do with LD provider from LaunchDarkly React client SDK. We're also going to bring in a use flags, which is going to let us evaluate our flags in themselves. We'll head down to the bottom of our application here, and we're going to go ahead and bring in the LaunchDarkly provider. So for now, we're going to replace this with the with LD provider component. I configured a VS Code snippet to make this a lot easier to type out. You can find this in our documentation pretty easily. And we'll go ahead and put that app back in at the end. So what this is effectively doing is wrapping our application in the LaunchDarkly provider, which is gonna give us access to those feature flags. We need our client side ID. So I'm gonna switch into LaunchDarkly real quick. Here I have an empty LaunchDarkly project. You see Lightspeed React in my test environment. I'm gonna press Command K on my Mac. If you're on a Windows, it'll be Control. And we're gonna go down to this copy SDK key for current environment. And we're gonna copy the client side ID. Go ahead and plug that in. This option tells us to store the initial flag values in local storage for part of the bootstrap. So we wanna just leave that as default. And once we save this, we're good to go. We have the LaunchDarkly React Client SDK installed. It's configured and it's running with our React application now. So when we do our startup of our React app, we'll be able to consume it. We'll go ahead and bring up a terminal. So we'll do a new terminal window. We'll do npm run start to get this running. And we'll switch over to this window and we'll bring it up to explore. So this is the default React application that's built when you use Create React App. It's got the React logo spinning, some basic text. So let's go ahead and bring in a couple of things to start to change this around. I'm gonna switch off screen real quick and bring in another component that we'll use. So we'll replace that logo from React with the LaunchDarkly logo using a feature flag. So we have this code here that's the image that's brought in for the React logo. So what we'll do here is we'll bring in another import. So we'll do import LD logo from, and we'll use the path of it. So it's ldlight.png, need a slash in there. And now what we're going to want to do is bring in a flag that will let us evaluate which one should be displayed, whether we want the React logo or this new logo. So it's important to note that this code is actually running currently on my local workstation. If we switch back into that window, we can see it's up and running. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to create a flag inside of this application for LaunchDarkly. So what we're going to do is before our return, we're going to declare out a image switch variable. With use flags from LaunchDarkly. And now for this actual component where we deploy out the actual logo, we're going to use something called a ternary operator to evaluate what should display. So we'll use our nifty little brackets. Ignore that angry squiggles. They will go away eventually. We're going to bring in that flag name. So image switch. We're going to tell it that we're evaluating. If that evaluation comes up as true, so the flag is enabled, we want to bring in some type of code. And if it's not, we'll use the existing code. So I'll go ahead and wrap this in that existing code. We are good. So the new code that we want to use is going to be based off of that LD logo that we created up here. So we'll go ahead and copy this. Oops, close that. Copy this text here. Throw that in. And what we're going to use is that LD logo that we created there. So now before I save this, I need to go into LaunchDarkly and create that image switch flag. So this is going to be our first feature flag that we're creating. So we're going to switch back into LaunchDarkly. We'll go ahead and do create new flag named image switch. Switches between logo images. We'll make sure that SDK is using the client side ID is checked so that we can use React. And we're going to do this just as a Boolean true or false flag. So true is new logo. False is React logo. We'll save this flag. It's created. And now if we switch back in and save our application, we can see the new version is built. The code's been generated. And if we switch back in, we should see the old logo present. We go in and enable this flag, save changes. We can see the new logo is displayed. So talk through a little bit of what's happened here. Once again, we bring in the image switch object that's using the LaunchDarkly flags. We create a ternary operator that's going to evaluate if image switch is true or false. If it's true, we ran this code that brings in the LD logo component. If it's false, we bring in the old logo. Then within LaunchDarkly, we created a flag that maps to that same feature flag that is just a simple Boolean true or false flag. With it on, it registers the new logo. If it's off, it serves the old logo. In our next video, we'll look at how we can continue to release new functionality into our application by bringing in different flag types, like our string flag type, to dynamically change aspects of our page. We'll also look at how we can load different React components using a feature flag as well. Really hope you enjoyed watching this video and getting your kind of first primer on using React with LaunchDarkly. Looking forward to you watching the next one. Have a great day.